Hello, my name is Aaron. This tutorial shows how to use the ruler in Microsoft Word for Mac. First, we're going to display the ruler. Then we're going to use the ruler to indent the first line of each paragraph, create hanging indents, and add tabs. Plus, don't miss the bonus section at the end, which shows a shortcut to set page margins from the ruler. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365 for Mac. These steps also apply to the single purchase versions of the software back to Word 2016 for Mac. If you're on a PC, please see my previous tutorial, How to Use the Ruler in Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. To display the ruler, select the View tab in the ribbon. From there, ensure that Print Layout View is selected, and then select Ruler. A horizontal ruler should now appear under the ribbon, and a vertical ruler should appear on the left side of your screen. If you want to hide the ruler later on, deselect Ruler in the View tab. If your vertical ruler is missing, you can display it by selecting the Word menu, followed by Preferences from the drop-down menu. When the Word Preferences dialog box appears, select View, and then select Vertical Ruler in the Show Window Elements section. Finally, select the Close button. To indent the first line of each paragraph in your document, begin by placing your cursor in one of your paragraphs. Then select the Home tab in the ribbon. From there, select the Styles Pane button. When the Styles Pane appears, select the Select All button. This option will select all the paragraphs in the document without selecting items you most likely don't want to indent, such as headings. Next, move the top ruler marker to the right to the desired indent length. It's important to note that you may need to re-click the top ruler marker to enact the change. Before we move on, note that you can press and hold the Option key on your keyboard as you move any of the markers on the ruler to see precise measurements. A hanging indent extends the first line of a paragraph farther to the left than the rest of the lines. To create a hanging indent, place your cursor inside the paragraph, or select multiple paragraphs if you want to create several hanging indents simultaneously. Avoid selecting the entire document with methods such as Command plus A, because you'll select headings and other items that don't normally have hanging indents. Next, slide the bottom triangle marker on the ruler to the right. The square marker will move with the bottom triangle marker. In Word, the Tab key on your keyboard moves your cursor to a specific location called a tab stop. Tabs can be used to indent paragraphs, but they can also be used for other purposes, including creating single and multi-column lists. To begin, press Command plus A to select the entire document, or select the portion of your document to which you want to apply the tab. If you don't select all or part of your document before creating your new tab, it will only apply to the paragraph your cursor is currently in or newly created content. Next, click the Tab Selector button on the far left end of the ruler until it changes to the symbol representing the tab you want. The left tab places the left aligned text to the right of the tab stop. This is the most common tab stop. The center tab centers the text on the tab stop. The right tab places right aligned text to the left of the tab stop. The decimal tab aligns text based on the first decimal placed on the tab stop. The bar tab creates a vertical line at the tab stop. Technically, this isn't a tab, it's formatting for multi-column lists. After making your choice, click the location on the ruler where you want to place the tab. The tab symbol will then appear on the ruler. You can place multiple tabs on the ruler as necessary. Each time you press the tab key, your cursor will move to the next stop. To remove a tab from the ruler, first ensure that no text or other content is selected. Then pull the tab symbol downward and release it. Now we're going to look at how to adjust page margins from the ruler. To adjust your right margin, hover your pointer over the center of the right end of the horizontal ruler until your pointer becomes a double arrow. You should see a tooltip that says Right Margin. Then slide the double arrow pointer to the left or right to adjust the margin. In theory, you should also be able to use the ruler markers on the left side to adjust the left margin. However, I have personally found that method to be unreliable in Word for Mac. Instead, I recommend double-clicking the dark gray area at the end of the ruler. This is a shortcut to open the Margins tab in the Document dialog box. From there, you can enter measurements into the top, bottom, left, and right margin text box as necessary. You can also choose Whole Document or This Point Forward from the Apply To menu. Finally, select the OK button. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Word for Mac, which offers many related tutorials, including how to delete extra spaces in Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.